It's a new day. You know what I'm saying? A new day. Brings a new problem to a brother, and all I got to say is thank God for my mother. Cause without my mommy dear, my life would have been a joke. Either locked up, laying dead, or still slanging dope. But nope, the Lord, he had a plan for me, and with his help, my mother made a man of me. Didn't blindfold me to the world we was living in. Taught me how to save my little dividends, so when I graduated, I'd have a little school money. But in the sixth grade, I wanted to be the school dummy, and flunked out of school with the flagpole, and left my mother dear at home with a sad soul. Because my mother worked the fingers to the bone, cause we was alone, and me, I brought an F home. My real pops, he broke out with the style, so I respect my stepdad for raising another nigga's child. So now we living comfortable, taught me the game and how to be responsible. But back then I couldn't see it, I wanted to be a grown man at 14, so the kids leaving and ended up in a big fight, and told me not to come home until I got my shit right. So now I'm living at my grandma's home. My grandma's strong, she's got 9 kids of her own, and keeping me ain't no big deal. But now that I'm much older, I see just how the shit feels, being kind-hearted, not wanting to tell me no, even though my grandfather just had a stroke. And now the money's low, and pretty soon a brother's gonna have to go, or either try to find a job so I can help out. I'm in the ghetto, I got to get myself out, and when I get out, I gotta try to pave the way so my family can have a better place to stay. I'm losing all hope, a brother's falling short, I can't cope, so now I'm slanging dope. And now my granny knows I'm doing wrong, she just praying for me heavily, take care of a grandson. And the Lord must have heard her prayer, cause he made me get a grip and got me on up out of there. I heard my mother say them streets is gonna kill you. You couldn't have told me nothing back then, but now I feel you. Now I'm 22 and finally got a grip on life. It's 1993, I put away my pocket knife and got a bigger stick to fight with. I'm young and black, so my choice ain't a nice pick, because we living in a concentration set, and every day we face to face with death. I've seen my homies go and come, and judgment day is just something we can't run from. So I know my number's coming up, so I gotta protect myself from suckers who be running up. And even though I hate killing off my own kind, I gotta be a man, and as a man I'ma defend mine. My brother Corn is trying to keep the neighborhood at peace. Don't fight each other, we got to stand and fight the beast. So united we stand, but we gon' fall quick, because we always trying to take another brother's shit. And the cops is in the same boat, just because we coming up quick, they think we slang dope. They shooting to kill, they gas ain't sparking dud. They shot my longtime partner Rudy in cold blood, and now the story's all twisted up. And if they gave the cop the chair, I really wouldn't give a fuck, because you left my partner's family with memories. And after hearing this, I know you don't remember me, but yet and still I find it hard for me to stay in touch. I see his parents, and then I start to breaking up, because I know what you did was wrong, but you won't realize until you dead and gone. It ain't no justifiable homicide, you never gave a warning, you straight up shot him from behind. But all the crying in the world ain't gonna bring him back. You give a gat to a black, he don't know how to act. But you gotta tell your story to the judge, not the imitation judge, the judge that everybody loves. And if the man upstairs grants you forgiveness, then in reality you took care of your business. But regardless, I know you wanna kill me, but I ain't going out